Forrest Day Jr. here. Today on Rolling Tape, we find out how you can make money with your film equipment, even while you're not using it. We'll talk with Brent Barbano. He's a co-founder of ShareGrid. He'll talk about the current status of equipment sharing. Now, let's roll tape.
This episode brought to you by Spoof Dance Film Festival. Make parody commercials and bring the funny.
Welcome to the show, Brent.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
All right. Now, tell me about ShareGrid. What is ShareGrid?
So ShareGrid is a community where filmmakers and creatives can rent their own equipment or resources to other filmmakers and creatives with integrated insurance.
Okay. Talk about integrated insurance. What is that?
Yeah. So the insurance has really been one of our most important aspects, I'd say, because when we first started out, we really tested the market and asked our audience, what's the most important thing to you? And everyone kept coming back and saying insurance, security. We want to make sure that whoever we are renting our equipment to, and we're talking expensive equipment. This isn't just DSLRs. We're talking, you know, Alexas and Red Dragons and grip trucks and things like that. They want to make sure that there's insurance involved. And so we really spent a lot of time, really actually 6 months, to build the first ever insurance platform for a marketplace, so that when you are renting on ShareGrid, you can buy an insurance policy up to $750,000 of coverage instantly within 5 minutes or less.
Now, how did you come up with the idea for ShareGrid?
So it's a kind of a two-part thing. So I'm a filmmaker. I'm a cinematographer in Los Angeles. I've been here for 9 years, and I was shooting a documentary in San Francisco about the share economy. This was in the fall of 2013. So we were interviewing people from Uber and Airbnb and companies like that. And that's when the idea kind of hit me that there really isn't this peer-to-peer marketplace for my industry. I own equipment. I know friends and colleagues that own equipment. It's just sitting there. It's idle. It's not making them money. They're not getting a good return on their investment. On the flip side, there's also filmmakers like me that it's really hard to rent equipment because it's so expensive nowadays. The infrastructure is kind of outdated. You know, rental houses are only open till 5. They're not open on weekends. It takes 2 to 3 days to get an insurance policy. And it's also just a very expensive kind of analog process, if you will. So I just thought this would be an amazing opportunity for me and my colleagues all over the world, really, to kind of work together and build a community that we can help each other out and allow ourselves to create, save money, and make money.
How can a filmmaker get involved in ShareGrid? Like I was telling you, I have a couple tripods, I have a glide cam, I have, you know, a couple things. They're sitting in my basement. I'm not using them. How could a guy like me or any filmmaker get involved?
It's really easy. You sign up. Within a minute, you can sign up and have a profile. We're only live in Los Angeles and New York right now, but we're aiming to go to Atlanta and some of the bigger markets very soon. And so you sign up, you can, you know, fill out your profile. It's just like any other social platform where you have a picture, you have a bio, you have social media links are very important too. And then you can start create listings. So you can upload pictures, descriptions, you set your price, you set your replacement value, things like that to create a listing. And I think I timed it once, and to set up a profile and create like your first listing is like maybe 4 to 5 minutes.
Is there any help on I don't know what my tripod's worth, or I don't know what my camera's worth. Are there any guides, or you got to kind of come up with that on your own?
Yeah. So we actually offer, when you sign up, we offer to help list equipment for you. I know because it can be kind of time consuming if you have a really big package and you have a lot of different parts to that list. It takes a lot of time. And so we offer a service where we will help list the gear for you, price it, set the replacement value, upload good pictures, things like that. We also have a tool that when you're listing the equipment, there's a suggested price tool based on that category in ShareGrid in the market. We suggest a price that keeps you competitive, that can hopefully get you more rentals. That's the goal.
Do the prices change from LA to New York to, and I know you're not in Chicago or anything, but do they change geographically, do you think?
Not so much. We haven't seen that yet. It's a marketplace. It's a free marketplace. So there's definitely a dynamic in the pricing for sure. But I haven't noticed any crazy trends between New York or LA actually.
Now, how do people meet up to get the equipment?
So right now, it's still very grassroots, let's say. So if, you know, I'm renting from you and you've got your gear, you know, in a setup in your garage or whatever, I would actually meet you at your place and we'd prep and exchange there and talk shop, et cetera. Some people also make arrangements to meet at third party locations, which is totally fine. Sometimes it's more convenient that way. And we have some other tools that and features that we're working on right now that I can't speak on publicly, but will absolutely make the exchange process far, far more easier. And I'm really excited about it, but it's not launched yet, so I have to keep that a secret.
Well, a lot of things like Craigslist or eBay, you can actually go to police stations and switch in the parking lots. And a lot of police stations actually have a monitored place.
Yes.
They'll have a place where you can meet up with a camera on it and help you that way. So this sounds like something you could use there. Talk to your police department.
Yeah. Yeah. It's kind of a similar model to what we're working towards. A little bit better than that. But yeah, definitely working on having a third party involvement.
Now, is there anything like this that you know of, or are you guys the one and only?
We're not the one and only. We have a couple other competitors.
You don't have to name them, but I'm just
I have no hard feelings against competitors because they validate what we're doing.
Mm-hmm.
Why would I have anything against them when they're doing something I think is awesome? It's exactly what we're doing. So I have nothing against them. I think we were one of the first that really started this, and we really were the first that innovated the insurance platform and making it professional. I would say that some of the other communities are a little geared towards like the lower budget stuff, the indie stuff, which we are too. We have DSLRs, we have low budget stuff. But we're also building a platform that is for the mid to big productions as well, for bigger, more professional productions.
Where do you see ShareGrid growing in 5 years from now, for instance?
Oh, man. We have a big roadmap ahead of us, and that's a good thing. We have a really clear path of the markets that we want to get into and the verticals as well. Right now we're really focused on the film and creative industry. We've realized over the last 2-3 years as we're exploring as we grow that there's really a need for us, not just in film equipment, but in photography equipment and spaces, and every artist and creative out there. So we're really focusing on that right now, and just expanding geographically as well. But there's companies that need us and other members that really could benefit from us. So there's a big roadmap, but I don't want to give away too much.
Have you gotten a lot of feedback from people who have used you? Like, you know, 'cause this is pretty new.
Yeah. We launched in, just over a year ago in LA. So yeah, it is pretty new. Absolutely. We get feedback all the time. For me, what makes me really happy is it's not so much that people say, wow, you saved me a lot of money, or wow, this is so cool, or you made me a lot of money. I mean, we get that a lot too. We've made people a ton of money. But the overall feedback we get is just thanks. People come up to me. I was just at a film competition last week. I was a judge on a panel for the film competition, and a number of people came up to me that are members of ShareGrid, and all they just kept saying was, thank you. Just thank you for making this, because I was able to do what I wanted. I was able to create what I wanted, tell the stories I wanted. And as a filmmaker, like that is such a good feeling that I know that I'm helping out my fellow filmmakers, because I'm in their shoes. I was there and I still am. And so that makes me really happy. So yeah, we get a lot of positive feedback.
Brent Barbano from ShareGrid. I want to thank you for joining me on this episode of Rolling Tape. Please like and share our page, our filmmaker page, and you can comment below if you'd like. We'd love to hear from you. I'm Forrest A. This is Rolling Tape.